Hello and welcome to the show. The Ferrari 488 is now in Forza 6, and naturally, I wanted to test this vehicle out. Thing is, it's got an awful lot to live up to. Its predecessor, the 458, was pretty much the benchmark that all supercars were measured against, and that is a very, very tough act to follow. And not only has it got to worry about its older brother, there are plenty of other supercars out there to give the Ferrari a really tough run for its money. So naturally, I wanted to put all of these cars together and see which one would come out on top. We started off by doing some racing, much like I did with the hypercars. We had a little bit of a roll-off delay between the vehicles with a reverse PI grid, just to try to alleviate some of the turn one chaos. Now, there are all sorts of vehicles in this group, from Ferraris, Lamborghinis, Porsches, and so on. There are a few sort of wild cards thrown into the mix, just to see what might happen with all of these cars. Now, turn one at Catalonia, the ACR Viper got a little bit unlucky. Got slightly bumped around by a Corvette, I think. This Lamborghini was trying to go around the outside of the Corvette. There wasn't a huge amount of space out there, but he did make it alongside. The Porsche ran very wide, ran out of road. The McLaren got up the inside of the Corvette to get the position. In the end, the Hurricane couldn't quite run it all the way. Still stuck on the outside of the Corvette as the Aventador goes to the inside to try and make the pass. And we're three wide again. That's twice in about three corners. The Hurricane has been stuck on the outside of that Vette going three wide. It does eventually make the move stick on the Corvette. The Aventador is up the inside, but can't quite have the run up towards the top of the hill. Now ahead of the Lamborghini is an Audi R8, as a Porsche is looking to get around the outside of the Corvette. Porsche ends up in a little bit of trouble. Lamborghini cruises up to the back of the R8, and the Audi really had no answer for these faster supercars. The GTR ahead runs wide, as do the two Lamborghinis, but they've both got enough speed to fight back. Now, at the back, some of the faster cars were trying to make our way through the order. This Noble was indeed a very, very fast car. It's to the outside of the Corvette around the final turn, sticks it alongside, and will absolutely muller it in a straight line. This Noble is a stupendously fast car for straight line speed. A Ford GT was trying to keep up. My 458 Speciale was trying to go as well. The Noble just makes mincemeat of everything down the start finish line, cruising past the GTR that was plummeting through the field. The Ford would get through as well. Up ahead, a 911 GT2 was having a look at the inside of the Hurricane, while the Lamborghini tried his best to hold it around the outside. Didn't really have an answer for that Porsche. The Ford was very, very good through the corners. The GT struggled a little bit with straight line speed and acceleration. The Nobles up the inside of the Hurricane, up the inside of the Aventador. It's going to get both of the Lamborghinis in one corner as the Porsche up ahead gets a bit of a slide coming out of that corner. The Noble spots his opportunity, has a long way back that one as well. They lead on each other a little bit on the exit, but the Noble gets his car alongside. The 488 is up ahead of them. Noble still on the inside. The Porsche about the only car here that can fend off the Noble for straight line speed. Porsche almost held it around the outside as well, ran across a curb though, got the 911 up onto two wheels, and that caused him some troubles. The Ford GT was trying to make his way through the field. Wasn't quite having as much success as the Noble. Kind of got stuck up. Me and the Ford got stuck up behind this Lamborghini pairing for a little while, and just, yeah, couldn't quite get past. The Ford is eventually, though, to the inside of the Hurricane through the first corner, try to get almost a double overtake, getting alongside the Aventador. In the end, the Aventador just starts understeering a little bit wide. There's nothing you can do. The Ford can just turn better. This GT is a lovely car through the corners. I will say that much. The Ford is a fantastic car through the turns. The brakes are incredible as well, as he gets up the inside, gets the car stopped on the Aventador. The Lamborghini does try to fight back a little bit, but it's a little too far back and doesn't quite have the acceleration to match the GT. At the front, and it was the McLaren 650S that was leading the way. Had made a good job of getting through the field, but he was coming under increasing pressure from the Noble. Through the turns, McLaren could just about fend off the M600. It could just about keep it behind, and certainly with a little bit of defensive driving, the McLaren could slow the Noble up. The thing is, as soon as we got to the straights, the McLaren had absolutely no hope. And you see, the Noble is all over the back of him through here, but the McLaren can place his car, and this McLaren is actually one of the surprises of the evening. It's a really very, very good car. I didn't quite realise how good the 650S was. And you can place your car very, very well and defend from the Noble, and you had decent acceleration out of the final turn, but once they kind of start getting up towards 140, 150 miles an hour, the Noble is gone. It will just outdrive the McLaren. They can brake at about the same time, and the Noble is just a little bit better. And then he runs the McLaren a little bit out a little bit wide around turn one. McLaren has to take a tighter line through the second part of that corner and just doesn't have an answer. You can see the Noble can just pull away through that third corner. Now he has got ahead. Now, one of the other big surprises of the evening, the Corvette Z06. I think one of the lowest PI cars here was actually holding on really quite well. There's a Lamborghini Huracan up ahead that throughout the course of the race couldn't really shake the Corvette. It couldn't really get that far ahead. The Corvette was actually currently beating the Saline S7. The Saline was another one of the wild cars that I kind of chucked in just to see how it would fare. The Corvette was struggling for straight line speed. Through the turns, it was a bloody good car. You could see it catching up to the Huracan. It was making a nuisance of itself to that Huracan. The Saline, though, was even better through the corners. It was gradually putting more and more pressure on this Corvette. The Huracan struggling with some of that understeer. As we come into the very technical section towards the end of the lap, a little bit of a lock-up from the Lamborghini. The Corvette's trying to go around the outside into this very technical section. That is a fantastic overtake from the Z06. That is really very hard to do through that corner, and the Lamborghini has to give way as they come around the final turn. Problem is, the poor Z06 has no answer to the Lamborghini's straight line speed. And while the Saline is not particularly fast in a straight line, that would get mullered by a lot of the cars here for straight line speed, that would cruise past the Corvette. So yeah, the Corvette did an incredible job for holding on for so long against these cars. Through the corners, in the end, it didn't really have the straight line speed to quite compete with some of the fastest vehicles here at the front, and it was the Noble that would go on to take victory. He was kept relatively honest by the 911 GT2. As I said, that is the only car that could really do much about the Noble's straight line speed. However, around the turns, the Noble was the slightly better of the two. The Porsche would come home in second, ahead of the McLaren 650S in third. Right at the back, there were some cars that struggled a bit in this first race. The Audi R8 and Nissan GTR did not have a good time. They were very, very far off the pace. They were relatively close to one another. The Nissan made a bit of a mistake into the final chicane and dropped back. Yeah, these cars got pretty much destroyed by the rest of the field. They're just not quick enough to compete with the other vehicles. So we move on to round number two. We went to the Road Atlanta full circuit. Again, with that little bit of roll-off delay, trying to stop too much craziness going on at the start. This McLaren found itself in a Lamborghini sandwich. Unfortunately, the poor Viper was not having a good day, getting nudged wide at turn one once more. The McLaren was all over the back of the Aventador as they come up to the top of the course. The Viper trying to fend off that Huracan. McLaren hasn't really got anywhere it can go. These are relatively fast corners down here. Quite nasty turns when you've got cars all around you. The Saline and Aventador both go a little bit exploring out there. The McLaren would get the pair of them with a much nicer run, as you can see up ahead. And Aston Martin 177 was having a fight with an F12. Had a look at getting up the inside. Couldn't quite do it. Once more, it was a relatively busy goings on this opening lap. The Noble was trying to make progress through the field as it goes side by side with the Ford GT, coming up to the 488 as they come towards this final turn. A long train of very fast cars through here. The F12 gets a wheel on the dirt, somehow saves it. Not quite sure how he managed that one. You often expect to see a big crash when cars do that. The Noble's to the inside of the 488 in the Ferrari. Can't do anything about the Noble. The Noble's straight line speed and acceleration is phenomenal. Then when he gets to a corner, it's so well composed. The Noble did have to check up to try and avoid running into the back of the Aventador. Gives the 488 a little bit of an opportunity. He overcommitted, and the 4GT would find a way past the Ferrari. Now my 458 was right behind the 488. There's a big slide from the yellow Ferrari And the Noble, while still had not quite found his way past, the Aventador wouldn't be long with his straight-line speed. The Corvette led the opening couple of laps, but was getting caught by a McLaren, and it really was only a matter of time. And that's not particularly surprising with these vehicles. What was surprising is how well the Corvette held up, certainly around these fast turns. Now, the McLaren, it was catching it, but it wasn't that much faster. For a car that costs so much more than this Z06, the Corvette really held on well through the turns. Problem is, as soon as they got to, even there was a relatively short straight there, the Corvette, it doesn't have an answer for the McLaren, certainly doesn't have an answer for that mighty, mighty Noble. Come through the turns, yeah, it can hold its own. Now it's got the Celine, the Ford GT is there, coming to line up. My 458 is sideways. The Noble is having a bit of a look, trying to find a way past the McLaren. Up ahead, the Corvette is going to get mugged by the Celine. The Ford had a wheel on the grass and hit it three wide briefly down the back straight. But in the end, the Ford would get the position. The Noble had the straight line speed to get up the inside of the McLaren and take hold of the lead. The poor ACR Viper was not having the best of days. It has to be said, the ACR Viper was, had been a little bit unlucky and then got stuck in traffic. I absolutely adore the Viper. It's a fantastic car. It was clear to see just how fast this car was through the turns. The F12, the 177 up ahead, had no answer to this vehicle. However, if they were fighting amongst themselves, if they could sort of block the Viper through the turns, well, the ACR has an awful, awful lot of downforce, an awful lot of drag, which means its straight line speed is not particularly high. It gets to the inside of the Ferrari. It very nearly gets the pair of them in one corner. As we round the turn coming onto the straight, it's still at the inside of the Ferrari. It would get that place a little too far back on the Aston, and then it just has no straight line speed at all down here, and the F12 would come flying back past. Yeah, the Viper had been a little bit unfortunate with these particular races. It was immense, though, through the corner. It was a stupidly fast car through the turns. I was in fourth place with my 458 trying to find a way past the 650S. I love the Speciale. I think it is a fantastic car. However, I was having a tough time getting past the McLaren. I was amazed just how good that McLaren was. I was putting under more and more pressure, though, as we come around the top of the course. I see an opportunity, try and get my nose up the inside. I just can't quite get far enough alongside. The 488 was coming quite quickly as he'd passed the Celine, as was the 911 as we come down the long back straight here. It's relatively even between my Ferrari and the McLaren for a while. Gradually, though, the Ferrari reels the McLaren in. I'm in perfect striking opportunity as we come down towards the chicane. I have a big dive under braking. The McLaren squeezes me and I'm stuck on the outside for the next part of the corner, and sure enough, the McLaren can keep hold of his position. And the more we fight like this, the more we were bringing the 488 up into contention. The 911 GT2, that was coming as well. I get a very big slide around the final corner. Not quite what you want to be doing. At the front, and the Noble was leading the way. This time was coming under pressure from the Ford GT. Through this first section, the Ford was absolutely flying. It could carry so much more speed through here than the Noble. Was looking every which way to try and get a pass done. The problem was, as soon as we got to the straight, the Noble would pull away. And the Ford GT is not a slow car in a straight line, but it is absolutely no match to that Noble. The Noble is just so incredibly quick. The only car that could keep up with the Noble was the 911. The problem is, the 911, I'm guessing being rear engine, actually had quite issues with the front of the car almost lifting up, going very, very light, especially down this straight. He had a little bit of a crash, or a little bit of an off, I should say, at the start of the race, so was fairly well down the order. And this is how the race would finish, with the Noble taking victory. The Ford put up a good fight in the end. Just his lack of straight line speed, I mean, it couldn't quite challenge the Noble. So the Noble gets a second victory ahead of the Ford in second. This was the battle for third. Still, I could not find a way past this McLaren. He did a fantastic job defending his position as we headed on to the final lap. You see the 911 GT2 has caught up, would breeze past the 488 for a straight line speed and would catch up to me and the McLaren very, very quickly. I was hoping to go for a big dive down into the chicane. The McLaren defends, though. I have to try go around the outside. You saw how the McLaren fended me off around the outside. I just wasn't in the right place. I actually put a wheel on the grass. That causes me some trouble as I'm slow off the turn. The Porsche is around the outside of me. me and we're going too wide into the final corner. This is normally a recipe for disaster. I slide, the Porsche slides more. Porsche actually tags the wall and ends up going round, loses out a position to the 488. I hit the GT that had, the driver tower had crashed after the line. So a little bit of a messy finish. I would get fourth though. At the back, the Hurricane had had a very bad race. The Hurricane had, really struggled around here, had fallen to last, was trying to overtake the GTR on the final lap. The Nissan was very sideways around the final turn. He very nearly ends up in the fence as well. And the Lamborghini, though, wasn't quite close enough to make the move stick. It was very, very tight between the pair of them. Now, of course, racing is not necessarily the most scientific of tests. As you saw, some cars got a bit of bad luck. Some cars got into trouble or just struggled at different tracks. And, of course, there is varying driver skill between the drivers. So I took each of the cars and went for a hot lap or a few flying laps with them around the Top Gear circuit to see how they would all fare. At the top is really not particularly surprising which car was going to be the fastest. The Noble M600 did a 111.0. Second place went to the Ford GT. It is half a second down on the Noble, though. A few tenths later, you find the Ferrari 458 Speciale. I do like the Ferrari. The Ferrari, though, and the Porsche, for that matter, both had a similar problem. Now, I mentioned about the Porsche wanting to lift the front wheels off the ground. That caused it some problems. It was a bit of a bugger to get around the high-speed turns here. And the Ferrari actually does the same thing to a lesser extent, but it does do the same thing, which is why it does struggle a little bit around here. The Saleen, very, very impressive, 112.7. It beats the McLaren 650S. The Saleen is slightly flattered by this circuit. There are not long enough straights for its lack of straight-line speeds to become apparent, and the Saleen is mighty through the turns. The Ferrari 488 is quite a way down the table, slower than the McLaren. The Lamborghini Hurricane is 0.7 of a second down on that Ferrari. The Viper, the ACR Viper, is only 0.1 off of the Lamborghini. The Aston Martin 177, very, very quick in a straight line, but it does struggle through the turns quite heavy. That's that car doesn't have a huge amount of grip. It does just beat the Corvette Z06 ahead of the Audi and the Nissan. With the circuit racing out of the way, we went to do a drag race between all of these vehicles. The Lamborghini, of course, four-wheel drive, gets a fantastic launch, as does the Saleen. Saleen gets a mighty impressive launch. The Saleen runs out of speed quite quickly, as does the Lamborghini. It's the Porsche that is streaking away at the front. The Noble giving chase. The Ferrari, the 488, does very, very well. The Lamborghini had a rather close finish between it, the McLaren, and my 458. Gonna go through a few different camera angles on this one. The Porsche struggles a little bit off the line, but that rear engine placement will help the car find some traction. And once it does get traction, it absolutely soars this thing incredibly, incredibly quick in a straight line. I think the Noble might have had a little bit of a dodgy start. They do kind of even out. It is very close between those two cars. Now, the Ford GT gets a half-decent launch, but we saw this car struggle a little bit with straight-line speed. And, you know, while it's beating some of the lesser cars in this lot, the 488, my 458, the McLaren, the Hurricane, all quicker than it. You know, the 488 was actually not that far down on the Noble. The 488 is a very, very quick car in a straight line, but it does struggle a little bit through the corners. The ACR Viper, well, you know, the Viper, the Corvette, the GTR, and so we weren't expecting them to compete with the top of this group. As I said, you know, the little bit wild cards that were thrown in for the sake of interest, really. The ACR does get ahead of the GTR and just about noses ahead of the Corvette. The rest of the field vanish off. The Audi R8 actually was better in a straight line than I was expecting it to. The GTR does start reeling in the Viper, but it's too little too late, as the Dodge would take victory. So for a little of a slow-mo look at the finish, 911 would take a relatively comfortable victory in this one, with the Noble in second. The 488, while is kind of a bit heavy, a bit sluggish through the turns, very, very fast in a straight line. The McLaren would just see off the Lamborghini, is only fractionally, and I was catching the pair of them towards the end. It just wasn't quite soon enough in the 458. The Ford GT, a fraction behind my Ferrari. The 177, despite an awful launch, does have good top speed, was reeling people in, so he does beat the Saleen. And the Audi, is relatively far ahead of this back group. The Viper, you can see, beats the GTR, which beats the Corvette that GTR was pulling towards the end of the race there. So our final test for the cars was the 0 to 100 to 0, so not only testing the acceleration, but also getting the car slowed down again. Now, the Hurricane has the advantage, of course, being four-wheel drive, can get a very, very good launch, but it is quite heavy and doesn't quite get stopped as quickly as the McLaren. Now, there is an element of lag in the replay, so kind of ignore that the brake locking up going on. It's very hard to keep track of it. My 458 was not quite as good as that McLaren. I was really impressed with the 650S, but I do beat the Hurricane. The 488 is very similar to my 458. The 488, more power, quicker accelerating car, quicker in a straight line, but it is heavier, not quite as good on the brakes. Incredibly close between the pair of us. The 177 did struggle a little bit with a launch, but actually got a very good run in this challenge, just beating the Hurricane. And there's also a bit of laggy wheel spin going on. The joy of a Forza replays. The Corvette, we know it's down on kind of acceleration and speed to the cars around. It still does a relatively good job, though, of completing this challenge. The Noble, mighty fast car. The Noble gets to 100 very quickly and gets stopped equally well. Would go ahead of the McLaren. The Celine, not quite so much. While it doesn't have the power of some of the vehicles around it, the acceleration and so on, does have mighty, mighty good brakes, so it does get stopped quicker than the Corvette. The 911, the main rival to the Noble, is very, very close back there. Incredibly close between a pair of them. The camera car goes to have a look at the distance there. The R8, another four-wheel drive car, quick launch from that thing, but it isn't as quick as these other vehicles. Gets stopped close, but can't quite beat the Celine. The Ford GT, not the fastest in a straight line here, but phenomenal brakes on that car. The GT has some of the best brakes out of this lot. So it goes into a fourth place for the moment, and the GTR is off. The GTR was past quite a lot of the cars before it hit 100 miles an hour. And we have our final vehicle, the ACR Viper. Not the quickest accelerating car here, but again, does have some mighty brakes on that vehicle. So to the camera, there's a few very close finishes. That's the 911 and the Noble. It's ridiculously close. But we're talking a few centimetres between those two cars. It does, though, go to the GT2. Fractionally, we are talking fractionally. McLaren in third, ahead of the Ford GT. Then we have the two Ferraris. We've already seen one kind of photo finish, and this is about the same as well. Between these two cars, just absolutely nothing in it between these vehicles. The 488 a little bit quicker accelerating, the 458 a bit better on the brakes, so incredibly close between them. The 177 actually did very, very well in this. You got a really good run to get it stopped fractionally ahead of that Lamborghini, but again, it was another few centimeters separating those cars. The Celine would beat the Audi R8, the R8 would beat the ACR Viper, the Corvette was a little bit down the way, and then somewhere, eventually, there it is, we'll find the GTR. Yeah, it's a little bit out of its league amongst this lot. I'm surprised at the number of sort of almost photo finishes in this particular challenge. So, on to the results. I used the same scoring system I did in the Hypercar Showdown. The Noble M600 would take first by a relatively healthy margin. The Porsche coming home in second, ahead of the McLaren 650S, getting third. Consistency with the McLaren is what did it so well. And I was really impressed with that 650 when I drove it for the hot laps. A fantastic car. The Ford GT, incredible car around a circuit, but it does lack the straight line speed. Great handling, great brakes, lacks some straight line speed. The 458 Speciale does beat the 488, and I do prefer the 458 there. The 488, great straight line speed, but it's just kind of a bit heavy and a bit wallowy. The Celine S7 did very, very well, very respectable finish from that, coming mid-table ahead of the Lamborghini Hurricane. The 177, decent straight line speed, but is a handful through the turns. The Corvette Z06 with another good showing from that car, a fraction of the price of the rest of the vehicles, and really did hold its own ahead of the Audi R8. The ACR Viper got a little bit unfortunate in the races, and the GTR was quite out of its league. So, the Noble is the victor here. A mighty impressive car, this M600. It's stupendously fast. As I said, you know, the 911 was the only car that really had an answer for this thing in a straight line, but this was so much more composed than the Porsche. It was much easier to drive the Noble quickly. I was kind of expecting it to be a little bit of a balmy machine. Actually, it isn't. It's a remarkably easy car to drive really very quickly. It's I was impressed. I was very impressed by the Noble. Admittedly, it does have the highest PI here of all of the vehicles. It's perhaps not too much of a surprise that the Noble would take victory. But yeah, it certainly is a very, very impressive supercar, this one. And yeah, a mighty tough one to kind of beat. The 911 was another car that was very, very fast. This GT2 RS let down by its handling. You saw it at the hot lap at Top Gear. While it has the speed to compete with the Noble, the front wheels like to lift off the ground at high speeds. It caused it trouble at Road Atlanta, having a bit of an off down the fast kink at the straight. It caused it trouble at Top Gear through the likes of the follow through. Those kind of corners, the front of the car wants to lift up. I don't think it quite gets a wheelie there, but it's kind of unloading the front wheels, and that causes it no end of handling problems. You just don't have the confidence in the 911 to push it in the same way that you do with the Noble. So while it has the straight line speed, its handling problems in the end let it down. It won the drag race, it won the 0-100 and so on, but it can't hold on to the Noble around the corners. It's just that bit more awkward to drive, and you know, that's where the Porsche fell down. The McLaren 650S was probably one of the big surprises to me in all of this. I was never a massive fan of the MP4. It didn't do it for me particularly. However, this 650S is a fantastic car to drive. It's actually only a mid-S-class car. It hasn't got the PI of the likes of the Noble, the Porsche, the Ford, and the Ferraris, and so on. But it really does hold its own very well. You saw it held me off for a good sort of 2-3 laps at Road Atlanta. The 458 was slightly the faster car. Again, you saw the hot lap at Top Gear. The 458 was a slightly faster car, but this is a fantastic vehicle to drive. The 488 is actually a little bit of a disappointment to me, in all honesty. While, yes, straight line speed is phenomenal in this very, very quick car, accelerating and whatnot, it kind of feels like just a heavy 458. It's not as fun to drive, this vehicle. It's not as fun as the standard 458, certainly no match for the 458 Speciale. Yeah, the straight line speed is good in the vehicle, but it's just not as good through the turns. It feels a bit too heavy. It doesn't feel anywhere near as lively as the 458s. Yeah, a little bit of a shame, actually, from this car. Not a bad vehicle, certainly, don't get me wrong. It's not a bad vehicle, but yeah, it's slightly outclassed by a fair few cars. The Saline S7 held up very, very well. This is one of the wild cars that I threw in. You know, I was just curious to see how it compete with these modern supercars. Around the turns, it was phenomenal. It lacked the straight line speed. The kind of similarities between this and the Ford GT. Now, the Ford GT was a great car through the corners. It lacked acceleration. It lacked some straight line speed when compared to the very fastest vehicles here. The kind of the story with the Saline, perhaps not too surprising. This is a relatively by far the oldest car out of this lot. It kept up though through the turns. It could put the frighteners on a few vehicles, and you saw its Top Gear lap time. As in, that's mighty fast from the S7. This is often a bit of a forgotten supercar, I think. And finally, the Corvette Z06 is the other big surprise in this one. I know how quick the ACR Viper is. I've done many tests with that over the past, and while it did get a little bit unlucky, you saw its lap time at Top Gear, how it can keep up with these supercars. And the same can be said for the Z06. This is a seriously fast car. While the likes of the Audi R8, the Nissan GT-R, they just couldn't quite keep up with the rest of the field. The Z06 got past the Huracan at Catalunya. It gets outclassed with acceleration and straight line speed. It gets outclassed by these cars, but through the corners, this thing is as fast as quite a few of them. That's quite an odd thing to say about a Corvette, but it's true. And I wasn't quite expecting this to do as well as it did. Yeah, it's down towards the bottom, and that's to be expected. But for, what, a third of the price as a lot of these cars, it's certainly not a third of the speed here. It's an incredibly impressive performance from the Corvette. Well, that is it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, goodbye.